I thought that was a pretty good game, exciting game. You know, last few minutes, we made some really costly errors. You know, some turnovers, a 5-point lead, we gave up a wide open three. So it's disappointing some of the mental breakdowns we had. But up until that point, I thought our guys did a good job hanging in there. It wasn't, you know, our best performance, but we kept being down 3 to 6 points, and we didn't let the game get away from us. We struggled with the free throw line, and, you know, with our turnovers, were really costly, but we stuck with the game plan, getting the ball inside, and it finally opened some stuff up for, you know, Maurice hit some big jump shots for us. And I thought Simeon and some other guys, Garrett did a great job off the bench. So really pleased with the win. Hopefully we can get a better crowd next Sunday and maybe try to sell this place out. We got to take advantage of the few home games we have. But I'm happy we were able to get a win. And Quinnipiac has a very good team, and I think they'll be very successful in their conference this season.
Oh, we scripted it like that. We wanted it to be a little suspenseful for the fans, you know, give them something to watch for their first home game. But, no, it was we made some bonehead plays down the stretch, and us upperclassmen, you know, we got to kind of close out games better than that, make better decisions. But we grinded it out, and a win is a win.
And, I mean, you got hot down the stretch. Talk about your shots were falling, starting with that, you know, and one on the three.
Yeah, I wasn't being aggressive enough in the first half, and I just felt that, you know, falling behind a little bit in the second half, I need to step up and make some plays, and I was fortunate enough that shots fell.
Talk about Marqus inside. What did he mean to you guys today?
He is an animal, pretty much. I don't know what to say. He, day in and day out, he has guys, you know, pulling his jerseys, shorts, draping on his arms and all that, and somehow he comes out with 32 and 6 rebounds. He's a special guy, special player, and he was huge for us tonight. And he was 8 for 11 from the free throw line, which is gigantic for us.
Seems like whenever you guys get down to a close game this year, you've been able to pull it out and pull out victories. What's been the big difference this year as opposed to maybe last year when you guys were losing overtime games in close games?
I think for a big part of it, we're making free throws a lot better this year. We're shooting the ball better from the line, from the three. A lot of games last year, especially the close ones that we lost at the free throw line. You know, could have easily put the game away, but missed a couple free throws and they hit a big shot. Or I think we're just kind of a little mentally tougher down the stretch and making free throws and making plays that win us games.
We were tested on the road with the first 10 games, and we came out 6-4, and we thought that was all right. We could have done better, but we wanted to come out strong tonight and show our fans what we have and what we're made of.
Did it help at all just in the end stretch, just being at home finally and having the crowd behind you guys?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in the beginning, I feel like it's more of just getting your butterflies out, and before the game starts, you know, everybody's coming to the game. But once you're in there playing, you know, you have home court advantage, and the crowd definitely plays a huge advantage towards us down the stretch and throughout the whole game.
Did